Thank you. out of the Son, out of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, in order to celebrate love and peace, let us call to mind our sins as we
Spirit,
one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My brothers, may the Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they were treated in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance." They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes? They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to another tenant, who will give him the produce at the proper time." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit." And my sisters and brothers, this is the good news of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, once there was a priest who gave, not talking about this priest or any priest, but there was a priest who gave long, boring, terrible sermons. And so, one Sunday he came in front of his congregation and he said, "You know what, congregation, I have been called away from new assignments, and this is all because Jesus wanted me to go." And then the congregation stood up, looked at him, and started to sing. And they sang, "What a friend we had." That's all you know.
My sisters and brothers, you know, we humans tend to represent things not as they are, but as we would like them to be. In other words, we often twist the truth so that it says what we want it to say rather than what it should say. Now, some theologians are concerned that modern Christians are doing that today when it comes to God. They are concerned that we are distorting the biblical idea of God. They are concerned that we are making God over. We are making God into the kind of God that we want God to be. We are doing this by stressing those qualities of God we like while playing down the ones we don't like. For example, we are stressing God's love, mercy, and playing down the fact that God is also a just judge. And someday we will have to give an account of our lives to him. Now this brings us to Jesus' remarkable parable in today's gospel. My sisters and brothers, it is remarkable because very few parables are as instructive as today's parable. First of all, it tells us the entire biblical story of salvation. It actually tells us what it is. Now check it out. The vineyard stands for the people of Israel, as today's first reading points out. The vineyard owner stands for God. The tenant farmers stand for the chief priests and Pharisees, whom God put in charge of this people. Now the servants in the first group, whom the owner sends to the tenant farmers to get his share of the grapes, are the early prophets whom God sent to Israel. The servants in the second group are the later prophets. The owner's son, who is killed by the tenant farmers, is Jesus Christ. The new tenant farmers, to whom the owner leases his vineyard to, well, they're the apostles of Jesus. They replace the chief priests and the Pharisees as the new leaders of God's people. So the second one were the apostles. Finally, the first leasing of the vineyard refers to the old covenant, and the second leasing of the vineyard refers to the new covenant. And so the parable is a beautiful summary of the entirety of the story of salvation. It's a miniature Bible within the Bible. Now, besides giving us a capsule summary of the biblical story of salvation, the parable also gives us a capsule summary of the biblical view of God. It shows us both sides of God. The God who is patient, who is a very patient parent, and the God who is a just judge. Like the vineyard owner in the parable, God showed incredible patience with the leaders of Israel. He gave them one opportunity after another to change their ways, time and time again. He sent prophet after prophet to them. When it became clear, however, that more patience was pointless, God passed judgment. God held them accountable for their actions. And so today's reading shows us that God is not only a patient parent who loves us very much, but also a just judge who actually holds us accountable for our actions. Jesus, the Son of God, reflects these same two dimensions of God. We sometimes forget that Jesus, like God, has a stormy side. The same compassionate Jesus who said to the people, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest." That's Matthew 11, 28. Jesus also said to those who ignored the needy, "Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire." It's Matthew 25th chapter, 41st verse. And the same gentle Jesus who said to the people, "Learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart." Matthew 11th chapter, 29th verse. But remember, Jesus also made a whip out of cords, and Jesus then drove the money changers from the temple. It's in John 2nd chapter, 5th. And the same loving Jesus who said, "Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge you before my heavenly Father." And he also said, "Whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." Matthew 10, 36. And so we find Jesus reflecting the same characteristics as does God. The application of all this to our lives is quite clear. We need to know that God is a patient parent. Now in the final verses of this parable, Jesus asks, "Didn't you ever read this in the scriptures?" And he asked, "The stone rejected by the builders has now become the cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous to see." In Ephesians 2nd chapter, 20th verse, he tells us that Jesus is the chief cornerstone in the structure of God's house. In this tenant parable that we read today, Jesus is revealing that though the religious leaders rejected him, he is the foundation of the Father's temple. He is the foundation of the church of believers. He is the one. My sisters and brothers, Many of the world's inhabitants or attendants have rejected God's Son and have failed to work with his vineyard. The population of the world, or the size of the vineyard, has grown, and the number of souls to be saved has greatly increased. So we must ask ourselves if we are working the vineyard as God desires. We must ask ourselves, are we disgracefully treating God's servants and rejecting his Son? What do you suppose the owner of the vineyard will do? For too many years, God was tragically looked upon as someone who was more eager to punish than to love. Now, however, the pendulum is in danger of swinging in the opposite direction and giving us an equally distorted picture of God. Distorted pictures, however, aren't what we need at this moment in history. What we need is truth. And that's what we find in today's reading. The gospel truth about God. God is both a patient parent and a just judge. So we, right here in this little bitty church on the south side, have to accept the fact that, hey, we have to step out and do something. We don't have to sit back and come here into this building and expect to be, I guess, made holy. It doesn't work like that. We, in this little small community, got to step out and do something. When we see someone who is less off than we are, help them. It ain't going to hurt you because you are not going to no way put yourself in harm's way. Y'all going to eat steak every day. You're going to have your lobster. But you know somebody ain't going to have nothing. So you can give them something. It is important for us to remain in the vineyard and to do what we are supposed to do. Help each other. Bring another soul with you. Don't travel alone. You know it's dangerous already. So travel with an army. Take the needy with you. Feel good about giving. It's important. It's essential. God has told us. He is going to be with us. He's got the point. If you're a serviceman, that means you've got the lead. And he got your flanks. And he's bringing up the roof. So what's the problem? Let's just go and learn to do it. And to walk around looking good. My God, it ain't even the world. We are happy people. We are Christians. We are on the battlefield. We are in good shape. Look at us. We look good. Well, most of you. But you look good. You look good. And in looking good, that means doing good. So the stretch out there. You know, take a chance. See a guy on the corner and he wants a dollar? Give him a dollar. It ain't on you, it's on him. If you go get a drink, that's on him. That ain't on you. But if you go out there and you do the right thing, or you at least try, you'd be surprised what might happen. You might be talking to an angel. You know, you never know. You never, never know. So it's important for us to just seek out the best that we can do. To be in the vineyard. To be a good worker. Now remember that God ain't all this, you know, I bless you, my son. No, God's going to come back one day and say, hey, you get to the left. You know, and you don't want to go that side. So in order not to go that side, do the right thing now. And you don't have to worry about later. But later might be like soon we walk out of this building. Yes. So we have to be aware of those things. And feel good about yourself, y'all. Feel good. Even if you ain't got nothing but a dollar in your pocket. Guess what? If you go home sometimes, you open up a purse or you look at a pair of pants, and wow, there it is, $20. You got your hat. Matter of fact, you didn't even know you had it. But you have it. And the Lord's going to give you all that stuff. Thank you. Like last week, what the heck? I was told you to get everything you want. And guess what you do? You just don't get it when you want it. You get it when God feels it, you get it in the hat. And he's going to give it to you. One new house, don't worry about it. Wait a while. One new car, don't worry about it. Wait a while. You did it. You did it. Because you know what? You already got it before. Why not get it again? Have a blessed day. Love you.
offense, our faith. I believe in God, thank you.
God's comfort so you. We pray to the Lord.
not when my brothers and sisters and my sacrifice and heroes live acceptable to God and my Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all the church.
God said, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your Christ, and through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate Good Food Service, graciously complete the sanctifying work in which you're pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere, give you thanks. Lord, the Father, Almighty, and eternal God, who laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons, you formed man and woman in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made. And forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ the Lord and soul. All the angels praise as a joyful celebration, we are made.
Thank you.
Savior. Look back on our sins, but on the faith of the church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live on way forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's offer someone a sign of peace, but let's not go all over the place.
Thank you.
for the people who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call for the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not the
but I don't say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We have been
plan. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. God is good. Every visitor stays with us this time. Every visitor and guest with us this time. We are at the Holy Angels. We believe that when guests come to us, they bring us God's blessing, but also they leave God's blessing. May God's blessing be upon you. Amen.
Thank you.
60. Extend your hands as we pray
for God's blessing upon sisters. Heavenly Father, precious God, I
want to thank you for the gift of our sisters.
The ministers of care and the extraordinary minister is asked to save the date and to plan to attend the 4th annual Day of Reflection. This will be this Saturday from 8:30 to noon. This year's theme is the sweet, sweet scent, the aroma of Christ. Our speaker for this mini retreat is Father Anthony Anneke, our pastor of Corpus Christi. Please don't forget to pick up your bulletins or the narthex of the church. The book called The Faithfully Being Part for this year will be available starting on October the 15th. Please, only family members that have died since our last service, please give their names in the books. The Knights of Peter Claver Ladies Auxiliary is having a sisterhood luncheon on October the 21st. Please see any member for a ticket. And we've been having some, try to keep our doors closed because, we have these animals that kind of drift in during this time of year looking for a place to stay. We got rid of a rhinoceros the other day. So we want to make sure you go slow, okay? We all are slow today. Well, the Chicago Black Catholic Choir is celebrating their 7 years of singing. So please come and have a very faithful evening. Our afternoon is going to be on Sunday, October the 29th at 4 o'clock right here at Holy Angels. Make a point to please come back here. We have tickets. Please just come and grab one of the choir members. We can sell you at least 400 tickets at one time. also, we'd like to tell you, we've had a lot of people that come here for Sister Helen, and we truly appreciate that. But y'all know, we're here every Sunday. We should be looking either like this or a little bit better every Sunday. So come on back. If you haven't been here, somebody told me that it's 1970. Come on back, all y'all graduated in 1932. Come on back, I would like to see you. Okay? We have lots of members here, And of course, we have, sitting in the back of the corner, we have John Calipus.
All right.
So it's all indeed a blessing to have everyone come home.
Let us say amen.
Amen.
Let us say amen one more time.
Amen.
And reach out and shake somebody's hand. Quickly, just shake somebody's hand. I got that from Father John. Alumni, Holy Angels, you've been taught by school sisters of St. Francis, or teachers you work with them, just stand up, please. For a brief reception, and we want to thank all of you for attending. I'm not used to talking in public, so you got to hear. God bless you. Thank you. Oh, and also, our deacon was correct. 8 o'clock Mass on Sundays, 11:30. That's the rocking Mass. But anyway, come on back.
You want to find? Oh, he's so beautiful.
Whosoever believeth in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen.